This is Wilson Puvula, and I'm a solution architect at AWS. In this video, we will deploy SAP S4 HANA application in a highly available cluster across AWS availability zones using AWS Launch Wizard. AWS Launch Wizard provides a wizard-based experience to size, deploy, and configure HANA-based workloads on AWS platform. AWS Launch Wizard is available at no additional cost. And post-deployment, we will test failover of SAP HANA database using third-party clustering software. Before we initiate the deployment, let's take a look at this slide to understand how we will use AWS availability zones to deploy the workloads. We will be deploying these instances in two private subnets in availability zone A and B. After Launch Wizard deployment is finished, we would see the SAP S4HANA application as shown here. The ASCS and ERS will be deployed across availability zones, and it will be clustered using a third-party software. And the database is also deployed across availability zones and clustered. The route table is used for routing traffic to these subnets. The sequence of steps for Launch Wizard are laid out here. It starts with launching all the EC2 instances and configuring the storage. The installation of HANA database is followed by HANA database backup, which is a prerequisite for HANA database replication setup. Once that is done, cluster configuration of HANA is performed. Then the application is deployed, and finally, the cluster configuration of the application is carried out. All of these steps are performed by Launch Wizard for SAP in less than 2 hours. Let's go to AWS console now and navigate to Launch Wizard. Let's click on SAP and click on Create Deployment. This screen provides information about the IAM role that lets Launch Wizard create the resources on your behalf. If you need more information, it's available here. Let's click Next. To save time, I've already pre-populated all the fields in another session. So let's switch to that screen and review the parameters. I've named this deployment as Launch Wizard Demo, and optionally, you can provide a description and any number of tags you need, such as cost center information. You can have unique configurations for your production and non-production environments. The configuration I selected populates all the network parameters, such as VPC, subnets, and security groups. You can also define encryption requirement for all the block storage and select appropriate options here. Once the parameters are reviewed, click Next. As we're deploying both application and database, let's leave the selection here as NetWeaver Stack on HANA. Provide a system ID and a user ID for SAP S4HANA. And the EBS volume type is selected from the dropdown. Let's leave this with default value. If you already have a transport domain, you can select it from the dropdown. Otherwise, leave the default option as yes. A unique system ID and system number are provided for the database, and default EBS type GP2 will be used for this deployment. Click Next. Since we're deploying a highly available S4HANA solution, we will select highly available deployment. Then we provide the details for ABAP Central Service. I selected SUSE Linux 15 for SAP as the operating system. If you want other operating system, you can select it from the dropdown. I have defined the unique host names and instance numbers and provided the CPU and memory requirements here. As you can notice, Launch Wizard also estimates the monthly on-demand cost for this deployment. Just follow the same steps for NQ replication server as well. Then we move to the DB section, where we select a preferred operating system and define the hostname and site name for our primary and standby database. A unique overlay IP and the cluster pacemaker tag is provided. This overlay IP will be used to send traffic to the active primary instance. Then the size of HANA instance is selected from the dropdown. Now we define our requirement for primary application server. We have more options to define additional application servers and pre and post deployment scripts if required. Once done, click Next. Let's leave the selection for the software installation as Yes. We chose S4HANA as our application and version as 2020. All the software is uploaded into S3 bucket and path is provided here. A master password and system number for primary application server are provided. All virtual host names and overlay IPs for ASCS and ERS are defined here. And finally, the virtual host name for the database and pacemaker tag for the application are provided. If you need backend agent installed and configured for backing up your HANA database to S3, then you can select the option here. Now let's hit Next to review all the parameters we provided to launch wizard. At this point, if you need to make any changes, you can use the edit option here. When you're ready, click Deploy. I pause the recording for the deployment to finish. Now that the deployment is finished, let's take a look at the logs. You can see the timelines here. The deployment began at 6:26 a.m. and finished 90 minutes later at 7:52, little under 2 hours. Let's now proceed to database failover test. Let me switch to a remote desktop where I've set up the environment already. Let's click on the deployment, Launch Wizard Demo 1, and I can navigate to the deployed resources from the Launch Wizard console. We have HANA database that's running across two availability zones in the Oregon region. And we have the ASCS ERS nodes running across availability zones 2A and 2B. I've listed the IP addresses and roles of each system on my SSH session for quick reference. Let's also take a look at the HANA database replication status in the HANA Studio. We're connected to host 10.0.4.4, and this IP belongs to primary database. The replication status looks active, and we are all set for failover test. In the failover test, I will simply stop the primary database host while a bad job is in motion at the application tier. And we will see how quickly the database is failed over and what impact it has on the bad job. To measure the failover time, we will simply use a stopwatch. We have an open SSH connection to the application server host, and we're using an SAP command to establish connection to the database. When the database is failing over across availability zones, we will notice that the connection is briefly lost and re-established. We have a second session to primary database host displaying HANA processes. We have another session here to monitor the cluster status. The cluster status shows the number of online hosts, all the cluster resources, and the primary and the standby nodes. Now let's create a bad job on the application. For this test, I'm going to use SGEN T code to trigger a bad job. Now that the bad job is created, let's monitor the job status. As you can see, the bad job is running. Now it's time to stop the primary database from AWS console and start my stopwatch. My session to the primary database host is now terminated as we stop the host. And this is an expected behavior. My application connection to the database is now disconnected. This connection should re-establish briefly. In my cluster, one of the hosts is now offline, and the resources are now failing over to secondary HANA host. My application is now reconnected to the database, so let me stop the clock here. The secondary HANA host should now be promoted as the new primary. So the connection is re-established and the resources are failed over to a healthy node. It took less than 60 seconds for the failover to finish. Now let's take a look at the bad job. And as you can notice, the job is still running uninterrupted, while the database failed over across availability zones. To summarize, in this test, we failed over a database while a bad job was actively running. The failover took less than a minute and was fully orchestrated via a third-party clustering software. The in-flight batch operation did not fail, and the user session was uninterrupted. I hope this demo was helpful in understanding how the clustered environments behave on AWS and how seamless it is to build highly available application architectures using AWS Availability Zones and AWS Launch Wizard tool. If you're interested in watching a demo of application failover test, you can find a link in the description of this video. Thank you.